Dr. Leonard, thank you so much for speaking with me today.
My pleasure.
Tell me a little bit about what you do.
Okay. So I'm primarily a pediatric nephrologist. I specialize in pediatric kidney disease. My research started out looking at the bone complications of pediatric kidney disease, and we realized there were a lot of risk factors for poor bone development in many pediatric diseases. So a lot of my work now is in children with inflammatory bowel disease, cancer survivors, a number of chronic diseases that impact bone health.
And how did you get into this sort of work?
I got into this work because during my fellowship in pediatric nephrology, I was funded through a training grant that provided support for nutrition research. I had to find something that had to do with nutrition, and I was realizing that a lot of our kids with kidney disease had problems with calcium and phosphorus. So on a nutrition grant, got some training in nutrition as well, and that sent me down the pathway of calcium and bone health in children with kidney disease.
Mm-hmm. You work with kids who have these sort of lifelong chronic diseases. Mm-hmm. Are there any advances in this field?
Well, I think Stanford in particular has really pioneered much of the work around kidney transplantation. So we do a large number of transplants here, especially in young children. Some of the real advances have been being able to transplant children and not put them on high-dose steroids. But we're finding, even though we're having advances in how we treat for them, they're still having a lot of bone complications. So transplant, we have to explain to the families, it's not a cure. It's really treating one disease for another. You no longer have kidney failure, but now you have all the complications of transplantation. So the advances are saving lives for sure, but now they're going into adulthood with other sets of problems they have to think about. And that same sort of thing is true, for instance, in the cancer survivors.
And for the cancer survivors, is it also bone health issues?
That's where we're looking at. We're focusing children who can be 10 or 15 years out from their cancer, in particular bone marrow transplant patients. We bring them in, we look at their bones, they have terrible osteoporosis, their body weight looks normal, but they actually have low muscle and high fat, and just starting to have an awareness that even though they can be 10 or 12 years since any medications and they're considered cured, we're now having a growing awareness of some of the complications that we are just starting to see because they're surviving into adulthood.
And it makes you think that there might be complications even beyond the bones that we don't know of yet.
That's right. I think what we're seeing going along with the bone problems is a lot of fat. Like I said, their body mass index is normal, but they have a lot of fat in the places you don't want it. It's in their muscles. It's the kind of fat you get around your belly. So we're seeing that goes along with insulin resistance and cardiovascular disease, things that pediatric oncologists need to really start thinking about and in terms of the implications once they transition to adult care.
Has there been any move sort of toward prevention of this? Now that we know that it's a problem, are there anything we can do to kind of head it off?
Yeah, now that's a great question, because when I first started talking to oncologists maybe 10 or 12 years ago and said I wanted to start thinking about some of the long-term complications, they literally said to me, we're just worried about them surviving.
That's
good to
hear.
We just need them
to
survive. And so I think now that we can show them that they're surviving but they're having these complications, we need to get a better understanding of what the risk factors are. Our research is now that we appreciate the magnitude of the problem, how do we prevent it and how do we treat it? And that's both of those are new areas.
Some of these kids are having their diseases sort of caught when they're children, mm-hmm. and then they get treated. But these problems, as you say, follow them throughout their lifetime.
Right.
Is there a continuity of care, or does it kind of drop off when they're transferred from the pediatric hospital to the adult world?
Yeah, no, there's definitely a drop off. I think once they move into adult care, many of them, for instance, the cancer population aren't seeing oncologists anymore. They're just seeing general physicians who don't have an awareness of some of these long-term complications of their cancer. So I think we really need to start to focus on that adolescent to young adult transition and making sure the care providers who assume responsibility for these kids appreciate some of the comorbidities they bring with them.
The hidden costs of these treatments.
Mm-hmm, exactly. Yeah, just starting to appreciate how significant it is.
Dr.
Yeah.
Leonard, thank you so much for
sure.
speaking with me.
My
really
pleasure.
Appreciate it.
Thank you, my pleasure.